Bismillah, walhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back to our series, The Proofs of Prophethood, the Light and Nubuwwah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. As we mentioned in our introduction, we are presenting this series in three phases. The phase before Nubuwwah, what occurred before the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam received prophethood. The phase during prophethood, after the commission of prophethood was received by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the proofs of his prophethood during this phase, and the proofs of prophethood after the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had Nubuwwah, which means after his life sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And these are the three phases that we're going to present this series in. So the first one that we're presenting today, inshallah, is the vision of his mother Aminah. This is the first proof that we want to bring that occurred before the Nubuwwah, before the actual prophethood of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We find Ibn Sa'd that he reported that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his mother, she said, when he was born, there was a light that issued out of my womb and it lit the palaces of Syria. We find also Ahmed and Adami, they reported something very similar to this. We start with this narration because chronologically it is the first cited narration related to any miracle connected with the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and what an amazing miracle it is indeed. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was born in the year 570 or 571 CE, according to the Christian era. That's the meaning of CE, meaning after the advent of Isa alayhi salam. When one studied the history of the world at this time, they will find that there were basically two major powers, the Byzantine Empire and the Persian Empire. And more specifically, the time right before the birth of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from around 510 to 515, with the fall of Antioch, Damascus, and Palestine to the Persian Empire, up until 624, with the Byzantine recapturing most of his lost territory, we witnessed the most intense wars between the two major powers. And most interestingly enough, Syria literally lies smack in the middle between the two major powers. And you can see, as we want to emphasize this point, you can see the map here where Syria lies between the two powers of the Byzantine and the Persian empires. Strategically, just see how Syria lies in between, and keep this in mind as we consider this prophecy that came about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam from his mother Aminah. It can't be stressed enough how important Syria was to any major world power, geographically, politically, and economically. And for the narration to cite the fact that the advent of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam would change these demographics long prior to the fact is a clear miracle and testimony to the status and proof of the role of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not only as a world leader but also as a prophet of God, as he declared and as we present in this as a proof of prophethood of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The actual narration states that the palaces of Syria were lit up from the light that issued forth from her womb as a result of the birth of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why Syria? There were certainly other major countries under the rule of either the Romans or the Persians at that time, but why Syria? And what is the meaning of this light? And what does history offer us to make sense of this providential vision of the mother of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Aminah, meaning the safe one to be trusted. In other words, we can take her word to be true, and most certainly history testifies to this fact. There was a very interesting verse in the Quran in which it describes a light coming to us, and this light will be accompanied with a clear book. The ayah, it reads, O people of the scripture, there has come to you our messenger, making clear to you much of what you used to conceal of the scripture and overlooking much. There has come to you from Allah a light and a clear book. The Quran, Surah 5, verse 15. Notice at the introduction of this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He addresses the people of the book. Why? Because at the exact time of this revelation, the people of the book who were represented by the Roman Empire were Christians, and they had regained much of their territory and power and was in more dominant power than the Persian Empire. And thus, what was coming next, which was the light of Islam, had more relevance to the major power, which were the Roman Empire at that time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said that a light, meaning the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Islam, has come to you from Allah, meaning this is a divine order for you to accept, not an arbitrary worldly occurrence. This messenger and this deen is from God Almighty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what He brings in the book, the Quran, is a clear articulation of the divine will of God. So therefore, follow it. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he leaves the world in the year 632 CE. With only a couple of years, his light and message embodied by his followers have reached throughout the entirety of the Arabian Peninsula. And within 6 years, that great prophecy that was witnessed and narrated by his noble mother, Aminah, was proved true in a light that issued from her womb at the birth of the blessed child Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, shown true at the conquest of Syria in 635 CE. And even to the present day, we find the presence and establishment of Islam. And where, in fact, the light of Islam not only lit up the palaces of Syria, but even further to opening that of Jerusalem in 638 CE, and even to this day, despite the turbulence and turmoil that we find there, is the presence of Islam in that holy and sacred place. May Allah give victory to the Muslims in Jerusalem, in Palestine, in Fukulu Makan, and all other places. Ameen. This particular proof of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and many more to come in this series is why we Muslims stand firm in our belief and conviction of the truth of Islam and the status of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. We invite you to accept the light and truth from your Lord and embrace Islam. هذا وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.